think we're ready to go. Let's go. All right. Now let me do some things right here. Let me get this set up. Okay, and boom, pin. There you go. Nice. All right. Hello, everyone. How are you? It's been a long while. Nice thumbnail. Thank you very much. It's probably very, very topical. Chris Chen in China. Yep, that's how it goes. Are you related to Gino Sa- No, I'm not actually. Hello. Hello from Australia, hello to Australia. Hello from Seattle, hello to Seattle. I am suffering, we all are, so it's okay, don't worry about it. Probably not gonna be for too long. Let's just tone this down just a bit. Maybe around 6. There you go. All right. So there's some changes going on with this stream, as you might be able to see. Gino Vanilla? No, I'm not. Coffee, water, and me. That is correct. Let's use the blackface pick for the live streams. I mean, I'm pretty sure that video is coming up today, so that's why I used it. That's the only reason. Lots of Americans around here. Hello from Peru. Like, Americas. All the Americas. Hello. Even though it's pretty late over there, I'd say. Close to midnight, I guess. Y'all should be sleeping right now. The music is great. Is it from Terra Nova? No. Actually, it is not. It is from my next documentary project, which is going to be out in probably less than a week. All things going well. This is from my next documentary project, which is not from Terra Nova. It's going to be a shorter one, though it is going to be like 44 minutes. It's going to be released before the Terra Nova documentary. I'm not revealing the subject matter for us. I don't know why, just to keep up the suspense. I'm not sure, but if you're subscribed to my Patreon, you probably know already. So anyway, please subscribe to Gino Samuel 3, the documentary channel, link down below, so you don't miss the next upload, which will be very, very soon. It's going to be a very exciting and informative topic. Will be able to find the music on Spotify? Probably not. No, I'm not thinking about doing that. I live in China. Yeah, that's right. I do. 8:34 a.m. in Siberia. God damn. Hello to... You ever see yourself moving back to Latvia? No, because I never lived in Latvia. What the hell are you talking about? 6:34 p.m. in California. Oh, it's not that late then, I guess. You're still thinking of doing the John Bulla doc? It's definitely not coming up soon. If I am doing it, it's not coming up very soon at all. I have other projects in mind. Is the North Sentinel Islands film coming soon? You guessed it right, I guess. It is coming out very soon. I live in China with my girl. I do. They should hire you to narrate every documentary ever because you have the most soothing voice in history. I'm pretty sure you're going to get bored of me if I narrate everything, but thank you for the compliment. Some people have issues with my voice, and that's fine. I guess this documentary stuff is not for them. It's for you. And you. We all know you used to play pro basketball in Latvia. That's really not true at all. What chat does Gino read? I read your chat. What do you mean? By the way, I also have a special pinned comment in the chat. It says, post your mega chat here. In case you don't know what a mega chat is, this is the closest thing I can get to a super chat, but since it's a mega chat, it's probably better. So it's pretty much the same, very much similar to a super chat. You go through the link, and this is the exact same thing that Twitch people use, Twitch streamers. And of course she knows about the lore, and she's watched everything up to like part 60, 62 or so. And Gina taught me to seek out stereo love in a mono life. Thank you very much. So if you go through the link, the Stream Elements link that's pinned in the chat is just a PayPal donation. However, with a special twist, you can write a message and write your name and specify an amount. And once you click send and tip, it will show up on the screen. So it's pretty much gonna be like a Twitch tip, basically. I can probably simulate what that's gonna look like right here. Actually, I can't right here. I'll show you real quick. It's gonna look like this, basically. Not too bad. 450 W quarters. Thank you very much, Georgie. God, I worked all morning just to make that W quarter animation right. Is there a dark spirit inside you that wants to make a James Cage White documentary? I mean, I might, but it's gonna be a lot shorter, though. How has working on the Chris documentary changed your life? Changed my life a lot, I bet. You sound so much more alive. Thank you so much. How many C quarters is that? I'm not quite sure. Inflation hits Quickville hard. Perfect, and the song is over. So now, while we're at it, let's jump straight into where we're supposed to be. I wish a bit more detail had been included, like since I'd witnessed the saga of Chris Sweezy, but what matters is that you kept to the basics. I mean, yeah, there's some things that I do leave out, but they're, trust me, they're quite unnecessary to be in the documentary. You know? Which cue is this? It's not a bad song. Okay, I'll leave it here. Anyway, Dalton is really struggling to get his words out right there. Isn't 10 W quarters 1 C quarter? Maybe it's changed since 2009. I'm not quite sure. Does MegaChat go to the Weezer fund? Sure, let's pretend that it does. I will put in the Weezer fund. Oh. I have my pen and paper right here. Have you used ChatGPT yet for your scripts? Nope, I have not. Chris was last seen at a Walmart. No, that's not true. Chris was last seen at a Game and Hobby store. Fanta originated in Germany as a Coca-Cola alternative in 1940 due to the American trade embargo of Nazi Germany. That is true. It's true. Have you ever considered putting your documentary on a service of some sort to expand your audience? Sure, I'll just put it on the service. Like, I'll just send it over to a Netflix. Oh. Rusty Roach tipped 44.20 W quarters. Well done. Thank you very much, Rusty Joach. Thank you very much. And that is another this. What? What the hell are you talking? Stargating or bigot? What? Putin will never catch a break after Christian being out of prison. Yeah, apparently I won't. How far do you think you're going to go with the Christian story? Are you going to go until he dies? I mean, I won't if I die first. So we'll see what happens. Anyway, let's go back to the task at hand. This is the chill quick stream after all. And let's hop over to my second monitor, which is my phone. Yo, I'm getting busy. Kara tipped 41 W quarters. Shout out to the Cum Boys, Steven, Ben, and the General Alexandru. Thank you very much for 41 W quarters. Now let's hop on over to the live stream. Where the fuck is it? Where? Oh my God, this is getting really busy. Hey Gino, thanks for documentary and music, good vibes. Thank you very much, Kirby. Thanks for joining this one too. this is not working out very well. My channel doesn't. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Why is this so long to refresh? What VPN are you using to stream on YouTube? It's not something that you've stream on YouTube. Well, that's difficult. I love listening to you while I work. I work nights here in Dublin. I might catch you soon in Dublin. Why do I sound like Christian? I really don't. What keeps the goat? Anyway, what VPN I'm using? Stop, can't you know when it's annoying? God damn it. Anyway, I'm using a special Chinese VPN through a proxy as well to get OBS working. Anyway, let's get on with the show. Jesus. Good golly, Miss Molly. Antarctica Doc, when? June-ish, possibly July now. I want to get the first documentary out before that, to increase the hype and increase attention at the channel. Anyway, let's start off where we left off. This is Chris wearing the class of 2000 Manchester High School seniors t-shirt right after the previous video, probably filmed immediately after. And Chris is going to reveal to us a very, very troublesome moment that Chris has that he has experienced. So let's see what Chris is talking about.
Captain's log, star date August 27th, 2010. Guess what? I have some interesting, fascinating news for you trolls out there. You all are aware of my recent dilemma with being able to download videos and digital comics being disabled. Well, I just got through talking with technical people at Sony, and they encouraged me to go through an option number 3 of searching for.
Hold on.
Corrupted data and clearing that out.
Excuse me, I did a doo-doo. Hold on. This. There you go. Sorry. I missed the mega chat thing on this channel. On this thing. Anyway. Now it's gonna work on this screen as well. So stop crying. We're good.
And the system suggested formatting my internal hard drive. And there was a misunderstanding between me.
Sorry. Anyway, thank you for the 400.
The
42.
Sony, Town America.
Quick quarters. Thank you very much.
I said yes. Everything I have worked for since March 2007, since I started, save data.
Christian, sorry. Now it's gonna be okay. I missed the delay. I missed the overlay. Sorry, on this screen. I got it up now. Sorry. You can write your message here.
There's nothing to destroy. You want to destroy my PlayStation 3? Well, in a misguided error, I just did it myself. So there's nothing for you trolls to be jealous about. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Feels like a whole weight has been lifted on my shoulders. In a way, you win. You win there. That's it.
That's it.
Leave y'all with that piece of knowledge. Let y'all contemplate. Have a... Especially to Clyde Cash. Let him contemplate the agony in the past few years everything.
So the story is, Chris formatted his PS3, and everything he ever worked for is gone on his PS3, which is an unfortunate thing for most people. Of course, Chris admitted that it's a sad event, but apparently he sees the good in it. As in, the trolls cannot troll him anymore because he trolled himself the hardest in that Chris's life story. Stay safe and have a good day. Anyway, moving forward. So during all this, Chris is communicating with the trolls as a fake troll. Y'all want to join the server? You do want to join the... No, we don't, John. Honestly, we probably should not share the Discord on the quick streams anymore. Just a heads up right there. I don't encourage it. Anyway, so moving forward. So Chris is going to make the best of a terrible situation and move his life forward. Let's see what this is. This is
Saturday.
This is unlisted, apparently. This is a very exclusive video. So this is... The weird thing is Satchmo used this moment in his documentary to show that Chris is growing when in fact he was tricked. That is very true. Satchmo got a lot of things wrong. I'm not sure if he was doing it on purpose or he's trying to communicate a false narrative with all these videos taken out of context and him adding new context. I'm not quite sure. Anyway, so these were privately shared with, I believe, Clyde Cash. And then, of course, they were uploaded later. And this was on August 25th, 2010. So Chris is gonna share... No, Chris, fuck. Stop it. Stop talking about Discord. Because the quick stream attracts too many bad actors into my God damn it, there is a video that I missed. Yo.
It's 28.
God damn it. 45W quarters. Shout out to the state of Virginia for producing so many lolcows like Christian and gorgeous George Yarrett. Justice for Jamie. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. This is Wild Man. Okay. I'm gonna see if I can find that video.
2010. Hold on, let me see. I make this video as a tribute to what I have lost, but also from which I have lost. I have lost something that was of important value, but I am able to let go. It is the spirit of myself.
4214, Christian W. Thank you. Sometimes I dream about cheese. This donation comes from Vancouver, BC, Canada. Thank you very much.
For our future, and now for the feature presentation on this video. What you are about to see is uncensored and unedited. My PlayStation 3 here in the backyard.
Holy shit.
The hard drive still in there.
Fudo. Thank you very much. Gino continuing the Christian doc keeps me inspired to save patience. Thank you very much.
I'm keeping the cover.
Thank you very much. I need to keep writing these down. I'm gonna have a thing
again,
later.
This is very graphic. So if you are weak in the stomach, especially as a gamer, look away. And I mean no disrespect to Sony Computer Entertainment America.
All you gamers are there out there. Please do not look at this. Actually, I got the next video that you linked in the Discord ready already. Actually, I got a. I see you right there. I see you right there. Don't worry about it.
Baker out the fine product.
I'm covering Beverly Hills, apparently. If you donate, sure. I think he kept the cover because he pasted over with it with like his own custom drawings. I think that's why he's keeping the cover. So anyway, this is a graphic gamer moment. I hope it doesn't destroy a PS3 or something. This is actually apparently a very exclusive PS3 that is very special and very valued, especially today. It's like backwards compatible to like PS1 or something. So, Chris destroyed that.
Vessel
of my loneliness within the past 3 years of
anguish.
I bid you fond fare-do. Adieu. Fond fare-do. Let's go.
Farewell.
Is that a functioning PC that he's hammering it over? That's a PC, right? A desktop. Is that functional? Whose yard is this madman in? I mean, that is Chris's yard. He has a very, very big property. I mean, Chris's family has it. Puts on the gardening gloves to carry the brick. He got tired.
Has the Spider-Man 3 text on it. The first time I came out, it was $600. Holy shit.
Crushed. Unplayable. The deed is done.
Are you sure about that? Moving further forward.
So Chris apparently did not do a good job.
It's an AC?
Or a mini fridge?
Air conditioner. Air conditioners look like that? Holy shit.
I'm used to air conditioners looking like something more futuristic and less boxy than that. Anyway, so Chris did not do a good job at destroying that PC, that PS3. He barely put a dent in it. Maybe it still works. So he's gonna drive over it.
I'm like, it's like I'm watching a snuff film. I mean, I guess it is. Just as horrifying as a snuff film for all you gamers out there. I wouldn't know because I'm not a gamer. Check out Geno Cinema 4 for all your gaming content.
Window AC. I don't know. It's old AC. Okay.
Prop from the set of Terra Nova. Ba-boom. Ba-boom. It's gone.
I don't have a box AC. No, I don't.
I'm just thinking back on this. Did I feature the PS3 humping video in this stream, or did I miss that video as well? Like, damn you, sack fatties, you know, that one.
And he did it again.
From GTA.
So, I forgot to mention this detail. If you're familiar with the series in Part 30 especially, you would know, but the reason Chris destroyed the PS3 now after it got bricked is that in the troll forum, they were scheming because they knew that Chris was reading everything they were writing, so they were specifically trollishly trolling him. Fuck, it's getting confused. Anyway, the trolls are pretending to be trolls. is the gist of it. They're making up fake troll schemes for Chris's attention so that Chris believes them, but they're not actually going to go through with it. So the plan is that the first person that was to be able to destroy Chris's PS3 and have it filmed will get $9,001. So Chris had this bright idea. Initially, for some reason, he thought that he was going to do... He was going to destroy it himself as Jenkins Jinkies. And then get the money. And then buy another PS3. And that was his original plan. Anonymous tipped for 4420. Hey, Gino's Grant, thank you for the content. Big homie. Thank you very much. I should stop writing these down. Anyway. So that was it. But apparently, for some reason, Chris went back on that whole Jenkins Jinkies idea. And he instead did it himself. I'm not quite sure why. Why did Chris destroy it himself instead of Jenkins Jinkies? That would have been much more entertaining. He was actually thinking, he was talking to Jackie about this. He was thinking about making up a fake audio conversation between Chris and Jenkins Jinkies. And they were all like gonna talk to each other about it. But he decided against that idea, and he decided against being Jenkins Jinkies for these videos. I have no idea why, but he did it. He really did the big brain. Chris was playing 3D chess. Too bad everyone else was playing Jenga. That's so sad. He's worth 9,000 intact, destroyed, worthless.
Well, you get the idea anyway. It's useless. Broken.
Are you sure about that?
Well, right over a car, it smashed through the brick. They thought I hit on the metal part and the heavy plastic. But still, when I plugged it in, it did not turn on. Actually, it went into standby mode, but that's all as far as it went.
Still went into standby mode. Those things are tough nuts to crack, huh?
That's all as it went. So right now I'm going to finish the job. Finish the job.
For all you gamers out there, you should probably close your eyes for the next minute or so. Got a switchblade out. Looks so tough with that... sleeveless shirt. What's in his other hand? Is that another knife? Because he was doing this. I know he had one knife in one hand. Does he have another knife in the other hand? Or was he like he was doing this? Going in British style. Hood chin. Nice. I had a switchblade too. My father gave it to me.
Broke a whole bunch of stuff.
Good. It's broken. Great. I'm happy for you, Chris.
You tell me. It's still good. It ain't now.
It ain't good now.
Seems like we have an echo already, audience. So... I will really show you that I am really seriously moving on.
I don't think I've featured this video in the documentary, honestly. I have no idea what this is. Honestly, I really don't know. This was posted 5 days later after the original destruction, more or less.
To you, the final trail of destruction. Including everything I have dissected from the dead PlayStation 3 console. Including the... three hard drives I have used all throughout the original 60 gigabytes, the 120 gigabyte, and the 500 gigabytes. Prepare for destruction.
This is something to add to my extended, remastered version of the series. I've seen these as pictures, like Chris displayed the ruins of the PS3, but I did not see this video ever, I'm pretty sure. Is he gonna do it again? Holy shit, I really did not see this. I missed this completely. Man. Okay, I think we get the point. You actually plan on making a remaster of the early episodes? Yes, I'm planning on remastering the whole thing, yeah. And releasing it on Rumble only. I didn't forget about it, I just didn't know about it, honestly. I can't believe Chris can drive and I can't. You know, it sucks. It really does. It sucks that I'm in China and I really have no business driving here.
And now, if you'll excuse me, I will collect the pieces to be put into a dumpster. Have a good...
Okay. So, Chris destroyed the PS3, Chris filmed it, and sent over the videos to Clyde Cash. Next, I believe it was Clyde Cash and Surfshack Tito that were going to arrange the drop-off, the money drop-off. Oh, that's much better, John. Thank you so much. Check out the Patreon for more epic stuff. Thank you very much, John. Please check out my Patreon. Do you have any STD or awards? Nope, I don't think so. Where in China are you? I'm in somewhere in the middle. So Chris and Surfshack Tito and all those others. Hoops, Hoobastank. Thank you so much for the tip. You're a good man, Gino. Thank you so much. Oh, yeah, 69. Anyway, YouTube is lighting its graphic consoles on your platform. Citizens of China. You're making me distracted. Anyway, so what's going to happen is that Chris and Surfshack Tito arranged a pickup at the Fashion Square, I believe, and Chris was waiting outside of a Starbucks or a Subway, and he was waiting for a woman with big boobs and a tattoo of a pickle on her boobs, because they're all trolls and they all love pickles, you know. So as Chris was waiting for this pickle-breasted woman, Archie Bunker, our old friend who previously filmed Chris dancing around at Fridays After Five, he came back and filmed Chris waiting for his $9,001 to show up, but it don't show up. Apparently Chris, that's gonna come later, actually. One is the loneliest number that that's so sad. Two can be as bad as one. It's the loneliest number since the number one. Damn. Chris looks normal here. No is the sad. Imagine if someone just went up to Chris and asked, "Hey, what you doing here?" Oh, I just destroyed my PS3 because trolls told me that I would get 9,001 American dollars if I destroyed my PS3. So I'm waiting for a pickle-breasted woman to give me the money. There you go. What are your thoughts on The Chase? Never really watched The Chase. So, the pickle-breasted woman did not show up. So then Chris emailed back and forth and then demanded that they send him the money in a manila envelope in unmarked bills or something like that, because Chris saw it in the movies that people liked to get unmarked bills, you know. And then there was lots of back and forth through emails, and then Chris was like, "All right, keep your money. I don't need it," you know. Basically like that. I wonder if the word stalking was more common in the early 2000s. The trolls wouldn't have done the in real life hidden cam filming stuff. Do you think the high school graduating class ever had a reunion? Possible. But I mean, how would they find all the alumni without like emails or Facebook or something like that? You know, if that happened, Chris would probably get wind of it, no? Anyway, this is a bit after that. Actually, no, I have no idea what this is about, so let's just review and see.
September 6th.
2010.
Chris had to count up the days. September 6th, that's about a week afterwards.
I am not dead. I am very much alive, healthy, and well.
If you have to make the video and say to people that you are not dead, I'm pretty sure that you're not dead. Just by uploading the video, I'm pretty sure we can guarantee that.
And I aims to keep it that way.
Yes, I'm really enjoying
it. Don't believe any goddamn rumors from the dang trolls. Because you know they all gonna be falsified.
I set up my account on Rumble a while back, but I set it up wrong, so I'm not sure if I can change it. So don't subscribe or look for me yet.
And I'll tell you all something else.
I'll let you know once it's ready.
She's still underground. Because you know they all gonna be falsified.
And there was another troll thing that the trolls were discussing for Chris's amusement, for their own amusement, but for Chris's attention, is that they were fake planning to dig up Patty the dog from Chris's backyard. And they were not actually going to do that, but they just wanted to make Chris think that they would do that, so just to see his reaction.
And I'll tell you all something else. Patty ain't dug up. She's still underground. All the trolls are doing between their forum and what they spread about in their dang rumors is just blowing a bunch of smoke. So what do you, should you believe a whole bunch of smoke? No.
I don't believe in smoke.
Because all there is with the smoke is just a fire web lies.
Fire web lies.
So there. And also, I am going to ignore the trolls, and they are not going to bother me anymore. I am regaining control of my life. They have played with me for long enough, mm-hmm. And they're not going to play with me anymore. I'm not going to let them.
Nope.
And also, I will say another thing. Haters gonna hate.
Pew. Was that a whip? Anyway, that was interesting. Have I ever smoke wed? Nope, never. I love your series on part 24. Listening to it on Spotify just entertain. Thank you so much for reminding me. I have to upload part 75 to Spotify.
This is for you, Jacqueline, my sweetheart.
Okay, so the Jackie arc. The Jackie arc is in full swing now. Jackie is his love interest now through and through, and she is influencing his videos from this point onwards, and she will influence the next 30 videos or so. Jackie, of course, being Alec Benson Leary. Since all the... Gino loved the new album. You're a genius. You're the Mark Zuckerberg of music. Thank you so much, Light Sephiroth. To ignore the trolls, sure you will. Anyway, so this is Crash Test Dummies in the background singing. Mm-hmm. And this is of course a Jackie influence.
I want you so bad, you know. I need you. You completely complete me so much. It's so hard to explain. I mean, you get me so excited. You get me energized. I just want to jump.
That's how happy he is.
You get me so excited, especially when I do things for you that you enjoy, that I helped you to, I help put together for you.
This is great.
It's just really awesome. Besides, as I said on their website, we're so much imagining many things. And you know, I could do a lot of fancy things for our first date, but you know. Yeah, that's a drawing right there.
I can't see anything.
Yeah, sure. Got a little gamey thingy here, but you know what? It's a good way for Jeff. Especially since I did the drawings first hand by hand. And for our first date, like I said, I would do a fancy, but I'm a simple kind of guy, you know. A nice little dare for two, maybe a movie, walk in the park, that sort of thing.
It's actually difficult to sing that.
So my fantasy day is just mostly simple, really.
There was this girl who...
A little bit more of you. I
meet you at your, I meet you over at your place or wherever we decide to meet up. And then we head on out for our lovely day. We can go catch a movie. Maybe go see Disney.
This is Chris and Jackie's date idea. These are.
Or we could go to an amusement park.
Were these images ever released officially?
Ride the Ferris wheel. Now we're together, enjoying it.
Yeah, we are enjoying it.
And then we go to restaurant, depending on whether where we would feel like
McDonald's,
fancy,
Taco
or,
Bell.
Inexpensive.
You know.
But this one was fancy. The one I put together for the first day here. Anyway, we just enjoy each other's company and the food.
That's Little Big Planet levels,
it
actually.
It can be candlelit. Think of that as part of the
family. No, we don't talk about Christian on a daily basis.
And then you just raise me on the way to the park where we can enjoy
happy birthday tomorrow, some cans.
I can push down the swing or just sit on the grass, whatever. Enjoy the moonlight. Magic moonlight. And find a tree and make out. And then when it comes to the apex of our evening, I can take you up to our car and then take you back home.
Still have no idea what the hell is happening.
If you want to, we can go back in there and ruin my club. Our protection.
Good job, Chris.
Because I love you and I care about you very much.
That's why I wear protection.
More than anything. I need you. I need you, Jacqueline. I don't ever want you to leave me. I need you. I want you.
Okay, just
so much.
You're a little clingy there, Chris.
I don't ever want
needy.
You to leave me, because if you leave me, that would just leave me very sad. It would be so much heartbreak. I would be down for well over a month.
That's a long time to be down.
It. Don't even want to think about it. But I love you, Jackie. I love you! I love you, Jacqueline Romney. Come to me, or I will come to you. And we will enjoy, and we will dance the night away, or hang the day away, and see where it goes from there. You make me jump. You make me jump!
Where's your jump, Chris? Where's your jump?
I love you so much! Can't stand it. I really can't stand it.
I know why Chris is doing this, villain
nothing's
trope.
Nothing's gonna come between us, sweetheart. It's you and me forever. I love you.
Great.
Captain's Log, stardate September 13th,
anyway.
2010. I am making this video to make a public statement.
Okay, so there's the gays are okay again. Okay, so in this video, there's a sound in the background, which a lot of people attribute to Bob basically dying or, you know, suffering in the background, though it is very loud. So he's basically right in front of the camera as he's doing this. So I'm doubtful whether it is Bob. Someone theorized that it's actually Chris has the Mod Nation Racers game in the background, and it's like on a pause or on a main menu. And it's just the character standing there idle, and he's doing his like idle gestures and, like, you know, scratching his ass and yawning. And someone said that this is actually the yawn from the character on Mod Nation Racers and not Bob suffering. Believable? Possibly, but goddamn, it's loud. I really was not expecting that. Let's just observe and think about that.
Or hatred, or anything, any beef against
beef?
The Xbox. It is a good console, a very good console. About equally as good as a PlayStation 3, yet it cannot play Blu-ray, but it is still a good console and is just another gaming console.
Damn.
Just like, you know, I guess just like PS3 is another gaming console, another Wii. Or a Wii is another gaming console.
Yep.
Have you noticed there's a depreciation in the number of gaming consoles in the center? Because the gaming addiction is gone.
Gaming addiction is gone, apparently.
I have gotten rid of the hoarded systems and games that are open. I have hoarded the number of years.
Let me look at the screen, just...
I have gotten rid of the hoarded systems and games.
I can see what was
open.
Happening.
I have hoarded the number of years. And also, I would like to make another statement. I have no hatred or anger towards the gay men. None at all. No questions. Straightforward. I'm cool with you gays, you know? You go do what you want to do, just, you know? Keep it to yourself.
That's actually really funny.
That's all.
Just that sync up of saying, I'm cool with your gaze. And then his dad is dying in the background. That's probably the game.
We're all equal people. We have every right to live our lives free, however each of us individually chooses. So there.
Is that all you got?
Anyway, that's essentially that. Oh yes, I just remembered the other thing. I remove all hexes and curses to every single person I have ever around the world that I have ever left a curse on.
Chris is growing.
So consider yourselves cleansed.
Damn, I feel cleansed, honestly.
You're all forgiven. Every last one of you. Forgiveness.
Any plans after the documentary? Yes, more documentaries. Please check out Gino Samuel 3, the documentary channel, linked down below.
And with that, I bid you a good day. A safe one too. All of you.
Great. Let's move on. Let's move on to the insanity, which are the Jackie cosplay request videos. And then the first one being the classic, you know, Mr. Popo from Dragon Ball. You know, Mr. Popo, he's an interesting character. If you ever watched Dragon Ball, it's a great show. I recommend it a lot. And Mr. Popo's design is it means a lot more to people outside of Japan. Let me just say that he's a guy wearing a turban, and his face is completely black, and his lips are looks like a red banana on his mouth. And people towards the west side of the of society, they kind of see that as a very negative thing, you know, that you know, there was a Japanese band like in the mid 80s. They're quite popular. They got lots of hits, and they're basically like the updated Japanese version of those 60s doo-wop groups that were popular back in the 60s in America, and like the Temptations or the Platters or one of them, you know, Sugar Ray Robinson and all them. And of course they were largely black, so this Japanese group decided to do like dum, boom, bom, 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 wearing blackface. And that was fine in Japan, you know, because they don't have this racist culture, you know, with you know, the African Americans and slavery and all that. You know, they don't have that history, so that doesn't apply to, yeah, you know. But internet, this spreads around, and yeah, the more exposed to the world you are, yeah, the worse, the more careful you got to be about these things. God, Jesus Christ. Ganguro, no, Ganguro. Are talking about the deeply tanned women? Is that what it is? It's quite common for Japanese live action shows to do blackface. They're not really aware of how the heart is, how taboo it is in the West. Ethno state, yeah. Japanese don't understand the context exactly. Like there's a pretty famous city pop album by Takako Mamiya, I believe that's her name. It's called Love City. That's a great album. On the back cover though of the vinyl is a little statuette of a black servant boy, you know, from like 1910 or so, and yeah. Yeah. Anyway, Mr. Popo, let's go.
Hello. Are your glasses wearing a genie? Mr. Popo. I tell you a story. It is a good story. You will enjoy story.
I'm a Hakujin.
Once there was this boy who was born with some autism and yet made a few friends, but after his high school years, he lost his friends and was so tortured.
I love that rhyme. There's also a really good city pop album called Morgana. Is that the one by Gino Samuel? You should check it out on Spotify.
But bullies who
do I speak Spanish? I yeah, I do.
Senior thing. No.
I'm half tempted to cover this to the tune of but with Chris's lyrics. Just... Oh God. No.
Once was this girl who continued to have friends long after high school. She could have had her pick of men, but then
Pickleman?
She found the wayward lost boy.
Just I'm pretty sure someone else corrected me on this, but Chris had access to face paint, right? Or like body paint. And that's what that is, right? It's not like house paint. I just painted over his face. You gotta tell us when you are in Dublin. We'd love to say hi. Will do. Will do, Alex. Pickle, you have no sauce.
That was an eventful week
when that dropped. I like those extra ums.
In both worlds, their boys were glad.
Shoe polish.
They both saw each other's eyes. When they met up,
huh?
They both thought of each other very often. They had enjoyed each other's company.
Whoa.
Sweetly. Oh, roller
the hell?
Coaster ecstasy in fantasy. Their days were simple.
They look
and
smart.
They looked to be married and had their own boy and girl. It's true. Wait for marriage invitation.
He's covering by Crash Test Dummies.
Ain't no sayings of the fiddle.
Until now.
No sayings of the fiddle like this. Ain't no sayings of the fiddle. No sayings of the fiddle like this. A song your day wa wa ho ho hey ya ho. A song your day wa wa ho ho hey ya ho. Ain't no sayings of the fiddle. No sayings of the fiddle like this.
No sayings of the fiddle like this.
Ain't no sayings of the fiddle. No sayings of the
happen like this. A son your day, wah wah, oh ho hey ya ho. A son your day, wah wah, oh ho hey ya ho.
I feel uncomfortable.
Happy loving between me and Jackie. I love you, sweetheart. Boing.
What was the boing? What was the boing? ChatGPT is more sentient and sapient than Chris. Okay, great. Ain't no same with the fiddle. No, ain't no fiddle like this. Loved your work on the Super Mega audiobook. Thank you so much. Would you ever want to meet Chris one day? No, but I probably will. Actually, I probably won't. Why would that happen? Anyway, so this is... Is this the video against Lars? Chris's Lego? Yeah, so this is... Yeah, okay. So this is in response to Jackie's ex-boyfriend, Lars, who is a big, big old scary black guy, according to Chris. According to Jackie as well. I'm pretty sure she posted a fake photo of Lars as well. So Chris learned that Lars has this addiction to boats and all things boat. And is buying expansion packs for boats that he doesn't even own. And of course, these are all references to Chris's addictions and his own bad habits, which Chris doesn't get, obviously, because, you know, there's too many layers to jump over. So Chris tries to intimidate Lars by stepping on a Lego boat, you know. So let's see how that goes. Is the April Fool's video archived somewhere? My GIF missed it and wants to... it's public now, so please check out my more recent videos. It's up there. It's called Comprehensive History Part 74, April Fool's version. So it's public for everybody now.
Good afternoon. This message goes out to an ex of my dear beloved sweethearts, who goes by the name of Lars.
Lars.
Who had an obsession with model boats. And here is a Titanic-like boat. He is piloting it. Let's see what happens to his boat.
A Titanic-like boat?
Oh, look at me! I'm sailing in my Titanic-like boat that was originally for my girlfriend, who is now Chris's girlfriend. And today was our anniversary, this 25th of September. Oh no! What's this? A cyborg!
A cyborg, yeah! No!
It gets better, you know what? Because... Here comes the demolition team that finds the remains of the sunken ship. Boom!
Dude is insane. Dude is absolutely insane. Holy shit. He must be a masochist.
Oh, and here's the captain of the ship.
Sounds like that Titanic stream. Dude is fucking off the wall. Holy shit.
Weak as dirt.
I love how crazy Chris looks like. Chris looks in this shot. Also, keep an ear out for Barbara's sudden appearance at the very end of this video.
The consequences will never be the same. Lars, you are no match for me and my muscles.
Oh God, just. That really caught me off guard. No, he wasn't barefoot. He was wearing socks, which is like a step below insane, you know? So you're just crazy and not insane, you know? Okay, so September 26th, all washed up. Okay, is this more anti-Lars stuff, I guess?
And now, a very encouraging song. You've been trolled. You have probably been told. Don't reply to it.
to this guy. He is just getting a rise out of you. Yes, it's true. You respond that just you. You start trouble on the double. Well, he wasn't running stubble. You've been trouble. You should probably just fold. When the only winning move is not to play. You keep on crying, endlessly replying. You've been trouble. You've been trouble. Have a nice day.
This video portraying and projecting the anti-troll cyberbullying movement has been brought to you by Mindless Erasers.
We are the Bully Hunters.
Oil and Bullet brand bars, soap, and other things. Softer, smoother skin in a week or so. And not only that, it gets you clean and makes you smell good. I just use it to wash my hands. And I use it in the shower to wash myself vigorously. I certainly do not use any animals, my own jizz, or anything else other than Oil of Olay brand bars of soap.
I love that advertisement so much. I definitely do not use my own jizz or any of my animals.
And that's body wash and shampoo and conditioner. Available in anti-dandruff form.
Is there jizz available in it?
But anyway, Oil of Olay. Soft and smooth skin in the week. And make your hair clean. Have a nice day.
I don't know what the hell that was about. It was like, you've been trolled, and then Dove bar of soap. Not my jizz. I have no idea what the hell that... I have no words. One of the few occasions where I have no words. Okay, just like maybe, let's say two more videos and then we wrap up. Live chat has moved. What the hell?
Okay. Hello, Lars.
Oh.
I've got your email and I gotta tell you, you're a dang loser to hide behind a picture of a black man. A dang photograph. Anyway, it's over. It's over. You've lost. You're history. You're kaput. You had your chance with Jackie, but you lost, buddy. You lost. You kept concentrating on your dang boats.
What the hell is that? If Vice or A24 or Netflix approach you to develop a miniseries, would you do it? Of course I would. Though Vice is bankrupt at the moment, so probably not going to be Vice.
All day and all night, ignoring her needs and her desires. Now she's with a real man. I will satisfy her needs and her desires. And if you ever want to be happy with yourself,
he just farted.
You grow up.
He just farted.
You grow up. Oh man, I will satisfy her needs and her desires. And if you ever want to be happy with yourself, you grow up. You grow up. And you stop thinking about yourself. Yeah. You grow up. Stop thinking about yourself. Yeah.
I love this video so much.
You mess with me and her, you're gonna have to deal with me, definitely. Down to the last sweat or breath.
Great. Okay, last video for today. Pokemon. Let's go.
Listen, it's October 1st, 2010, and we're gonna go a good change of pace here. I have come to terms and realization. With the help of my sweetheart, Jackie. Anyway, I want to apologize to Michael Snyder and everybody at the Game Place for blaming them for all the troubles. Because you know, things have perspired.
That
led up to me getting kicked out was very much my fault. But most of the time, I was just either super stressed out. I only shout out loud outbursts twice.
If you had access to the phone call after Chris's father died, would you include it in the doc? Yeah, probably I would. Yeah, contact Jackie. This is Jackie. That. Yeah, definitely. This is Jackie, all over Chris at the moment, and this was actually prompted through their emails. They were emailing each other a lot, and Chris confessed, or like Chris was encouraged to apologize for his behavior at the Game Place and him being, you know, very aggressive towards Michael Snyder. So this is all these videos or not Chris's, like, his wish to make these videos. Chris was always prompted and prodded to make these videos. Always. Pretty much always. The trolls were goading him into making these videos because they're more entertaining than just reading emails. And this is the same thing with the Jackie arc here.
Twice. Ever. And yet even that shot Michael. And I apologized for writing that message on the cardboard box that Michael knows is aware of, out of anger in response to not being allowed to hook up the Wii so I could distribute the Electivire, the Magmar, and stuff for Pikachu to the other League to the other Pokemon League members to their Diamond and Pearl games. But anyway, I do not blame any of them. I am to blame for my getting kicked out of there. And I am sorry.
Mm.
Have a good day.
That was nice. Anyway, let's move on to this video. Next time. Let's switch on over to not that, but this. Boom. And we're back. We're back where it all began. So again, the music that you're hearing in the background is from my upcoming documentary, which is not Terra Nova the White Silence. It's something else. Something super, super serial, super, super exciting. Please check out and subscribe and hit the bell button on Geno Samuel 3, my documentary channel. The hub for all things that are not Christian. You really hated making apology videos, definitely. You don't forget to upload that. Of course I won't. I won't forget to upload that. Man, Rogue Internet is here. Grace Team 10 and 10, love you, Gene. Take it easy. Thank you so much, Hot Plastic. I got them joints. I got them double joints. I'm pretty sure. Eat my beans. I ate my beans. Because I only apologize when they think they're going to get something for it. Yeah, good point. God damn, you're a flexible. Yeah, that's true. That's true. I'm a flexible boy. Internet Rogue Man. Those curtains slap. Thank you so much for the curtains. It's like it gave me the curtains. Tipped 4690. Awesome stream as always. Thank you so much, Alex. Thank you very much for joining. I'm making a serial documentary. Close. I'm actually making a fork documentary. God damn. Stick my mail. Oh my god. It does kind of get me how much Kristen was able to complete it. I'm sure most quality YouTuber everyone was so much high, but it's still impressive. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I feel like that should be customizable for longer messages to stay up for longer. I don't know. Maybe I can just make that happen for everything. Love watching while I draw. On last music stream, you said something about an ARG album. Can you kind of explain on the idea? Nope, because it's not gonna be made just yet. It's gonna be a very long time away, so I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna talk about anything that's not too certain. Can't wait for Chris Chan apology video to have the lowest rank called Sonichu on everyone worst YouTube apology tier list. I love this queue. Give me money. Yeah, I know. Do I live in China? Yeah, I do. I do a lot. There you go. Swim trunks of Speedo. Yes. Do you think Kevels is a grifter? Possibly. I do not know the details, so I cannot say for certain. Chris's high-pitched voice sends me into a conniption fit every time I hear it. Fanta, while watching the series, I dare you. That's a good drink of choice. How many more videos do you think are left for a quick Project Gino? Goat, by the way. Thank you so much, Roberto. About 23. So one thing is just living in the Walmart? Probably not a thing. Maybe his mayor office is in the Walmart. Getting that China. I am. Definitely am. Anyway, so thank you so much for joining today. Thank you for your fun chats and your mega chats. Greatly appreciate it. And please don't forget to support Gino Samuel 3, the documentary channel for all things documentary that are not about Christian. Do any more covers soon? Don't think so. It's all pretty original for the moment. As to releasing some more videos from my most recent music album. It's called Terra by Gino Samuel. Please check out Gino Samuel on Spotify and Apple and Google Play, Amazon Music, wherever you may be. Shazam, Tidal, Deezer, whatever, wherever it's called. You ever have dreams or nightmares about Chris? Nope, I don't. What if Chris got through? Okay. That was a very short cue. That was the Krakatoa cue. Weezer cover. Yep. Maybe happening soon. Soon-ish. We'll see. Anyway, so thank you so much for joining. Thank you so much, John. That's a too many links there, but yes, please check out my Patreon link down below and also in the chat. I don't live in Japan anymore. I live in China now. So thank you so much for joining. Please check out my Patreon for all things Gino Samuel and exclusive. You're going to get some scripts, some behind the scenes stuff. Going to get some drawings and some voice acting as well if you're so inclined. Wiener cover. Oh, I love a wiener cover. Anyway, can I see the live emoji reacts? I do see the reacts. Yes, I do. You should drink every time he says Gino Samuel. It's a good idea. Anyway, this is me, Gino Samuel, wishing you farewell and a fond fair adieu. By the by. OnlyFans Gino, maybe for April Fools. I'll probably do that. It's not a scary place at all. It's not. Don't worry about it. Don't trust the scaremongering, the fearmongering. Kim Wilson has been Chris's longest platonic relationship ever. Ain't that true? Anyway, thank you so much, everyone, and I'll see you next time. I'm not sure when the next time will be. Maybe in 2 weeks or in 4 weeks. We'll see how it goes. Bye. Have a good one. Take care of yourselves and take care of someone else. Thanks again. Bye. I'm just chilling to the music.